Don't ever.
Your turn.
No.
What? Can you feel it?
Nope. And you don't need to tell me listen to Michael Bolton.
What? I can't snap very well.
Love puts you through the fire when love puts you to the test.
What?
You shut a minute. For a second. I'm pretty sure less than a minute ago.
I'll leave that up for you. Anyways, what's up, Jingle Jammies?
Thank you so much.
I'm McStud.
I'm Mrs. McStud.
And welcome to the McStud Show, Michael Bolton Friday edition, bitches.
Thank goodness you have a hurt back, because I was about to knock your ass straight off that chair.
You raggedy bitch.
Making me suffer for fucking a minute and a half.
You're a jingle jammy, too. Where did I get jingle jammies from? Right before, I have to click these videos before I start the video, or else I get an ad. And that was like a 15-second ad of Old Navy. And they're selling jingle jammies. So I was like, I want to use that in the video. So I stole that from Old Navy.
Hey, I was about to say something on this. Oh, I know what it is.
What's that?
What happened at Speedway?
Nothing. Mm-hmm. Nothing. Nothing happened at Speedway. I got monsters for us mm-hmm. for later.
Yeah, sure you did. Uh-huh. And you were in there an extra 40 seconds.
The card
well,
machine.
I was fucking dying.
The card machine.
Out in the car. Getting flirted with by the worker and watching a video on his phone.
Picture the dude, the comic book guy from The Simpsons, okay? You know those people that work at gas stations and, you know, you give each other a greeting, hey, how's it going? Good. How are you doing? Good. But you get some people that are like, well, how are you doing? Then they gotta talk, which I'm not there to talk. I'm there to buy my shit and get the fuck out. That didn't happen tonight. I was like, well, I just saw something funny. I was like, what's that? Thinking he's just going to tell me real quick. No! It's a 40 fucking second video on his goddamn phone. It wasn't funny at all. And I had to watch him like, oh, that's going to be a good laugh. Have a good night.
And I, at the same time, was choking on my own spit sitting in the car because I don't know what happened.
Another instance of getting flirted with some weird dude at Speedway.
Well, I'm dying in the car.
And it can't even be a decent dude. It's always got to be the weird ones. Like, remember Milky? The blonde dude at the Speedway in Pendleton?
Mm.
Looked like Milky from Me, Myself, and Irene?
Yes.
Oh, Milky. He'd be eyeballing me up and down.
Oh, yeah. He even saw your name tagging him by
No, that was the old child molester looking dude with the chomo mustache.
Oh.
Calling me Mr. Chad. I can't remember his name. It was like Bill or something stupid. No, Bill was that other dipshit over here in Fortville. But he never hit on me. But damn, like it's always someone stupid. Like Milky legitimately looked like he was going to fucking, like, murder me in my sleep after he raped me. Like he was like the Jeffrey Dahmer type albino. Yes. Oh, the puzzle time. This is McStud's Mickey's puzzle
Don't
time.
Don't tell me.
Okay. It's Just been a minute. A been it's a minute since Mrs. McStud had a Mickey's.
Eight.
Oh, that's easy.
What's that picture of that?
That right there, that picture?
Give it to me.
It's hay.
Hating.
Hate. Stop the hate. No ing. But you got it.
Oh, I get it. Hey, eight.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, eight.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
High five.
Wow.
Good job, Miss McStud.
Did you see that?
It took a little, it kind of flickered there for a few. Like old Edison discovering electricity in the light bulb. What?
Oof.
But anyway, it's there. It's Michael Bolton motherfucking Friday, everyone. For the first time in a long time, we have no kids at the house, which is really strange. It's eerily quiet.
Yeah, I kind of miss them already.
Like, it's so fucking quiet.
And we have been running since they've been gone, really.
Yeah. Like, we just got home, We got some delicious breaded tenderloins to eat. Tenderloins. Miss McStud has my favorite tenderloin. What?
No.
That loin is so tender. It's like Luke Bryan tender. Tender.
This is what I live with.
What? You love living with me.
You
wouldn't have it any other way. How's that Mickey's? It's been a minute for you.
Good, actually.
So you're not going to give them hell about the Mickey's ordeal either? Or give me a hell?
Well, you just burnt yourself on that one. Now I gotta say it.
All right, go ahead.
So he's been driving. He drives past this fucking Walmart at least four times a day.
Mm-hmm.
And we get all the way home four times every day, four times 5 days a week. So mm-hmm. 20 times a week he drives by this Walmart. And that's if he probably was there once or twice this week.
Yes, but you had I forgot you had your last Colt 45 last night.
We get all the way home to this video after we drop my child off at her friend's house. And he looks in the fridge and he goes, oh, fuck. I gotta go to the liquor store because I'm just going to go get you some Mickey's because they have Mickey's grenades down there and I didn't buy you Colt 45.
Long day.
That's a whole week. 20 times a week.
But you had them all through Thursday.
It doesn't matter.
I didn't need them up
you
until the day.
You knew that I was about to be, I mean, I forgot, that's math.
You raggedy bitch. Fuck you and your math, motherfucking bullshit.
You can count on your fingers. There's four. It's a four pack. So let's go. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Or if I had one Sunday, it sounds like I did. So I had one for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday would have been my last one. So it left me with zero.
Well, in my defense, I knew it was coming up. And I actually, Wednesday, I was like, oh, I don't need to get cold. You got two left. That was before we did our video for Wednesday night. And Thursday, yes, last night, I was like, man, I need to get you more Colts. This morning, what did I do this morning? I drove.
You had to go drive to get a humidifier at 1 o'clock.
Before that, like on the way home.
I didn't think you did that thing.
No, I didn't. I went straight home. Because I got home later because I had to get coffee.
Yes.
This morning. So yeah, I just drove straight home. Oh, you know, I didn't stop at the liquor store. I was like, well, I'll come back later. I never got the opportunity because it was about 15 minutes before it opened. I didn't feel like sitting there because I always have to shit in the morning. Sometimes, like, if it's already there, if I have other places to go, I didn't think about going to Walmart. I didn't really have anything to go to Walmart for other than that. But yeah, it totally slipped my mind. But I thought about it.
But you didn't make it happen.
I did. Like,
what happens at my desk if I just think about shit and don't actually do it? Guess what? I just keep thinking about it and then it never.
Well, I guess
done.
You're like everyone else at your job.
This is true. But fuck. I'm not that way.
No, you're not.
Why can't I stay in that place?
Mm-hmm. Did you see in the news that one of your favorite Big Brother guys is not coming back ever? Tyler.
Why?
I don't know. He just doesn't want to do it no more.
It's on the news?
Yeah.
Which one?
Well, I go to Google. Like, I'm logged into my Google.
So on my Google Tyler website. Big Brother?
Yeah. I don't know what website it was on. I just figured you might be interested in that. I was trying to think of something to talk about. Miss McStud.
Are you lying?
No, I promise. If I could pull up my Google, I'd show you. Because it said it for the last couple days. But Miss McStud got me into Big Brother many years ago. It's kind of weird that I actually got into it. And once I fully understood how everything worked, then I liked it. So this year was a little off because it didn't start during the summer like it normally does, but they eventually had it and it's over now. But
happy it's over.
Yeah.
For him.
If I tell her anything, Big Brother, she got to look. She has all these spoiler pages on her Facebook timeline too. So before the show's even on, she's looking too. Like, oh my God, I hope this isn't true. Like, what? Guess who won the HOH? What? Guess who won the POV? Babe. Hide those during the season. I mean, shit. And you'd be like, damn it. I'm like, what? I just found out something I didn't want to know. Well, hide them so you don't find them out. And then go back to the group later and, like, follow it again. Oh, my God. You're a whole mess, Mrs. McStud.
Seriously?
Yes.
Blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah. Now, the one show she tried to get me into was the what's that, Greatest Race?
Yeah, the Amazing Race.
Amazing Race, Greatest Amazing. I don't find anything great or amazing about it. She likes it, though. We don't watch that. We don't watch a lot of shows just because time permits. It's not, and all these shows are like 2 hours. Sometimes they're three. Especially when you wanted to watch The Bachelor and The Bachelorette, and then The Bachelor in Paradise comes on. So you never get a break from The Bachelor if you're actually watching it, except for like a month maybe in between. Then Big Brother comes on in the summer. And then we just have other shows. Like right now, The Voice is back on, so we watch it.
I didn't say he would never be back. I just said he's happy it's over.
Oh, I'll have to show you the website on my phone, because my phone's better than yours.
Well, fuck.
That's ridiculous. Why'd you burp like that? I'm going to stick my finger in your Mickey's.
Get the fuck off.
You know where this finger was before that?
Probably your ass.
I scratched my butthole.
You're so fucking...
I did not scratch my butthole with it.
Yeah, but you probably didn't sanitize them when you got home either.
Yeah, I did. I used a little squirt bottle out there.
You just wanted to say squirt.
Yeah. I did. Squirt and moist, two of my favorite words. Squirt, moist, and fuck. Fuck's my all-time favorite word. Fuck, 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 fuckity, fuck, 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 fucker. Fucking fucker. Fucking goddamn motherfucking fucker.
I was on the phone with Home Office. I had to call him about another issue today. Not round up my payroll person. And I said, what the hell? And I said, sorry. I said, I'm trying to figure out what I did. I never talked to that woman before.
Oh boy, this is a new experience.
Yes.
No, we just whipping out fucking inappropriate words for work with people you've never discussed anything with, not knowing how they are.
I just got on the phone with a payroll person that we cuss to each other.
And that's one of the biggest obstacles for me when I was working in a work environment. Like, you can't start off like, you don't know who the fuck you're working around, and now everyone's so fucking sensitive. Their buttholes are like irritable, like just by looking at them sometimes. And you never know who you're going to offend with shit. And I have a very colorful vocabulary, not like anyone doesn't realize that already. So it's hard for me not to, you know, run into something like, fuck! Like, it just comes out. Like, I don't think about it. And I have problems with the phrase, what the fuck? Especially at work, because anyone that has a job knows there's always some fucking idiots there, and you're like, what the fuck?
This time I was questioning myself, so I'm like, what the hell? Because what I wrote makes no fucking sense.
Well, at least you said what the hell, and not what the fuck. I mean, in hindsight, that was probably the better option of words. But still not good, but not horrible. I mean, what are they going to say? She said hell. Okay, well, I'm a religious person. Like, maybe you had a
and then I found out that my payroll person is actually off for this week's payroll, so I'm actually gonna talk to her again.
Oh god. Well, tell her you had a sermon flashback.
Oh god,
what the hell?
That's ridiculous.
Yes. I don't know how that would be used in church and to incorporate it with everything else that they preach about, but I think what the hell is a very... Do you see that meme? I had a squirrel moment. It said,
yeah, a squirrel.
It was like something. I went to church and yelled, fuck the devil. And they kicked me out. And like, I thought we were all against this thing, this guy. Oh. I guess you can't say fuck the devil at church.
No.
But I mean, it would make sense. Stay, like, don't let Satan overcome you, all this bullshit. Fuck the devil. Nope, you're out. You cannot participate in this church. Okay. That's kind of weird in a way. I mean, wouldn't, like I said, God, I just want, in the same sentence, God, I want the devil to shove his dick in my ass. And in church, that'd be almost like you're praying for it. I guess depending on how you word it.
That's ridiculous.
God, I really want the devil to fuck me in the ass. Or it's like, God, I really want the devil to fuck me in the ass. It's all in the wording. It was like, and for the religious, the people that do practice religion that watch us, I'm sorry. Not really. Sorry, not sorry. This is what I do on a daily. Offend and reoffend.
Yeah. What's on the next few moments?
Mm-hmm. This is true.
I just had a squirrel moment too.
Oh, what do you have a squirrel moment with?
I'm about to see if I have money on Starbucks.
Oh, your card?
Yeah.
So, well, you might have to put some more on.
Well, I might have enough for a free drink.
Oh, yeah. Oh, your points?
So I got 147, so I don't know how much it is.
I don't know.
Details. Sorry.
I do! Oh,
see. No, I'm 3 points away.
Oh, ain't that a bitch? 3 points? Three?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, those raggedy bitches. How are they going to set you up for
47 to 150.
Oh, ain't that a bitch? Well, with that being said, and how disappointing, just add another 10 bucks, 15, whatever. With that being said, Miss McStud, how was your day?
It's okay.
Just okay?
Yeah.
Not amazing?
No.
Are you sure?
You know, motherfucking day's amazing. Oof. Oh.
What about a day spent with me?
They have...
Oh, not the Christmas coats. Not the what was that one that we got in Disney World? Remember that one?
Yes, it was white chocolate chip mocha or something.
White chocolate something. Jesus, I'm not into big sweet coffee drinks.
They might have it already.
But that white chocolate macchiato mocha, whatever the fuck it is we got on ice, is fucking amazing.
Yep, toasted white chocolate mocha.
Yes, that's it right there. Toasted white chocolate mocha. But we always got it on ice. We got that on ice, didn't we? Yeah, we never got those hot.
I thought we got a frappe.
No, we got them cold. We drank them.
A frappe is cold.
Oh, whatever. Yeah, we made it with ice.
A frappe is like icy.
Yeah, we got them icy.
An icy?
Yeah, we did get them icy.
We didn't get iced. We just got icy.
It was iced. Icy. It had iced in it. It was... Or something like that. Yeah. But it was fucking delicious.
Yeah.
I I'm a huge white chocolate fan. I love some motherfucking white chocolate, white fudge.
The peppermint mocha was good too.
I'm not big into peppermint.
I'm not sure we tried the caramel brulee.
I know. That's too much for me. Like, when you get into caramel brulee.
I might have to do white chocolate.
Yeah. I don't blame you. When you get into the caramel brulees, that kind of ranks up there with eating ice cream for me.
Damn it, I never can see five.
I just don't want to eat the ice cream. Like, the ice cream tastes good. I don't feel good after having it. And I'm not even lactose intolerant. I love some milk.
$1.67.
Well, add some cash to it. What the fuck? What's your major malfunction? Huh?
Just doing the most.
You're always doing the most, Mrs.
McStud. How much do you want me to put on?
I don't know. Whatever you want. Whatever you need to get you a fucking...
I just need $10. Yeah, $10. $10.
Act like your son now. Can I have $10? Yes, babe, you can have $10 for your drink. Get it and enjoy it, because you have to work tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. I work next 2 days.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Really?
No, because the election's about to be over.
Who gives
we're
a
going
fuck?
On government assistance.
I did read something. One of my friends posted on Facebook, and it says... You'll know if Trump wins because I'll still be working the next day. If Biden wins, I'm keeping my fat ass at home and we're going to draw all the government assistance we can.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
I don't know what that has to do with the election because I don't watch anything
I really don't understand that. That's
a for real thing, I guess.
That's why we leave the politics to these dumb fucks. I'm not a political person.
But a lot of people that try to watch us are...
Yeah, this is true. Yeah. That's not something we get into. Though we have been watching, but I don't really care at this point.
Now I gotta remember I put money on my Starbucks card. To go by there.
What the fuck, Mrs. McStud? That's ridiculous. So, on a... Jesus Christ. On a lighter note, we're actually... this is, like, might be one of the last warm weekends this weekend, so we're gonna have a fucking fire. We're having a motherfucking fire. It's decent out.
Oh, we found a huge humidifier, too. I'm super excited about. You know you're an adult when you get excited about finding a humidifier.
Humidifiers.
Because my fucking eyes have been so dry, and then my daughter complained about it the day before.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you both had that same thing. You want to hear a fucked up story about humidifiers? So I get on Facebook Marketplace, thinking like maybe they got some cheap humidifiers. And you never know who you're going to meet on these. So I find... This set of three decently sized humidifiers, $5 a piece, $15 total for three. I'm like, shit, let's do it. I asked him, is this still available? Responded, yes. So when can I meet you? Tomorrow at 1, which was today at 1 p.m. So I'm like, okay. So we plan to meet in a place. So I go there, and it's a Kroger. And it's a very nice Kroger. It's like a super Kroger, really. It's like a Walmart Kroger, really. Yeah. Or a Meijer Kroger or a Target Kroger. I don't know how the fuck you want to call it.
Oh, that was the same one with clothes
machines. Yeah. So to be easy, I parked towards the end of the parking lot. This place is always busy. There's always plenty of people driving around. So I get there, I was a few minutes late, early, and he's like, give me 10 minutes. No big deal. I'll sit and wait. And then a few minutes later, on my way. All right, cool. And I already told him where I was sitting. I put my location when I was driving. He's like, I'm here. The dude is foreign. I mean, but after talking to him, I just don't understand why he didn't understand the context of the fucking texting, why I did what I did. So he's like, I'm here. I'm like, okay, where are you parked? He's like, I'm out by the front door. And it's hard to get any parking spaces up by this front door. It's pretty much full. So I'm like, okay, I'll come up there. So I actually go up there looking for a parking space, and I pass one. Well, see this guy standing outside. I don't know where he is. He didn't even tell me what he was driving. So I'm like, okay. So I turn to come back around, and he messaged me, I think I saw you. Did you go back into the parking lot? Yeah, because I don't know where you're at, and I'm trying to find a parking spot. It's become way too complicated at this point. So I come back around, I find the parking spot I was going to get. I start backing into it, and we got a camera that shows the back of our car, but I always, you know, I look at that, but I always look around me in my mirrors and shit. Everything looks clear. So I'm backing up, I hear this, I'm like, what the fuck?
Because he knows that I will be one motherfucker to show you.
I don't just back into shit, ever. I don't think I've ever backed in anything. If anything, like, I might have misjudged the distance of the front of my car and bumped a wall in a parking garage before. But I've never backed into anything, even without the camera. Like, I've been taught how to back up fucking vehicles and shit. So I'm backing in, I hear this, I'm like, what the fuck? I'm looking in my mirrors, I'm looking behind me, the car seems to be a good distance, the distance on the camera from the car is there, I'm like, what the fuck could I possibly be scraping? So I fucking put the car in park, I go around, I don't see nothing, everything's clear, and someone leaves a fucking empty Smirnoff bottle, glass vodka, full fifth, not full, empty, on the ground. This is what I fucking run into, and I start pushing, my tires pushing across the parking lot. I'll shit my pants because I'm like, I don't just hit people's shit. Like, what the fuck? So I throw it in the grass. And I'm trying to message this dude. And I was like, I parked over here in front of the Starbucks sign. So I get out and I'm looking and I got my phone out. And then he comes over, he's waving. And this is a dude that wears a mask while he's driving alone. So I had my mask, you know, just to be safe. In case, like, some people don't care if you're wearing it, but I just wore it, you know, to be courteous. So I put it on, and he comes out, and he's like, well, my wife sold the other ones, and I scrambled around to find you one. I'm like, okay. And he has this little owl humidifier. Cute little owl humidifier. Now, when the post said $5 a piece, $15 for three. He's like, I know we were selling them for $15, and I'm like, well, how much is that one? He's like, $15. I was like, but the post said $5 a piece. He's like, no, that's not what my... I was like, hold up. So I had to pull up the post, and he's like, oh. He's like, okay, I misunderstood her. So I give him my $5, and I go home with my pretty little owl humidifier.
And it's a 1 gallon one. Mm-hmm. So it's then cute. You have to wash it out every day. So it'll could fit in my child's room. Actually, that'll work probably pretty well in her room.
Yeah. But yeah, that was a whole fucking mess of it. Like,
but we got this big ass nice one now.
Like, I understand why the dude wanted to meet up front. I really do, because you never knew who you're going to meet, especially on Facebook, Craigslist, anything like that. I get he wanted to be public. The spot I was in was people coming in and out all the time. There's people walking around out there and shit.
Yeah.
And I'm like, it's not that deep. It's not that deep. But damn, you put me in a tough spot to try to find a parking spot up front. not even telling me what you're driving. I don't even know where the fuck I'm supposed to park to even be in a remote area of you.
But he knew.
And he didn't even park. He just pulled up there in the drive. Oh, God. And opened his hatch.
So you did eventually know what he was driving.
Yeah, because he's waving at me. I see his car, and he's like... And he just parks it right there, like, not even parking a parking spot. And we're, like, over here negotiating a fucking owl humidifier. Yeah. That happened today. That's all I can say about
that. You thought if he would have noticed his wife sold him, the humidifiers, he would have texted you. Or even Facebooked you back. And I'm like, hey.
Yeah.
Just in case we didn't only want one.
Yeah. And his phone had horrible signal. He's trying to pull up the pictures. His phone was not getting good reception there. Mine pulled it right up. I'm like, hold up. This says $5 each or $15 for all three. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Don't be charging me $15 for this tiny little owl fucking thing.
That's not the deal. Posted it wrong.
That's not. No, his wife posted it on his account. And I think there was a miscommunication between him and his wife. But this dude does drive around in a car alone with a mask on. So, I can't.
That affects the brain cells.
Mm-hmm.
I swear to God, ever since mask, you've had to wear a mask. It affects the way people think, the way people hear. It affects their overall IQ.
Yeah, you try to talk to someone, like, hang on, let me take this mask off. I can't hear you.
They really are. They,
I'm like, what?
I swear, like, everybody's, like, IQ dropped, like, 20 points.
It's almost like when it snows.
And driving. Yes.
Exactly. We said it at the same time. Snowing and driving, like, especially in the state of Indiana, happens every year. It's common. As soon as the first flakes of snow hit the ground, people drive like fucking idiots. Every year. Never fails. Never fucking fails. And Mrs. McStud and I have seen so many fucking wrecks this week. It's fucking crazy.
Yeah, we
and not even good ones. Like, there have been bad ones. There was a bus. Was the bus this week or was that last week? The bus might have been last week. Had a school bus. Like, a car ran a red light and the bus hit the car. Unfortunately, no one was... The driver of the car, I think, went to the hospital. But the bus driver was okay. And there was one kid.
The car driver went to the hospital in serious condition.
I would imagine get hit by a fucking bus. That's what you get for running a goddamn red light.
He didn't get hit by a bus. He hit the bus.
I thought the bus hit him. No, the bus hit him because the whole front end was off the bus.
No, that's true.
Yeah.
Well.
You get hit by a bus. This bus has got some... And then we saw someone turn in front of this fucking semi. And it wasn't your regular semi. It was an oversized Lowe's semi. Like, this motherfucker ain't stopping.
Yeah. Anytime
soon.
Lowe's too.
I'm like... Oh my God, that's all you can say with some of these fucking idiots. And I don't typically see them in the area we're driving at tonight like that, but damn, it's like just...
Thought we were on Pendleton Pike for a minute.
Yeah, it's just fucking stupid. I dislike it a lot. A lot.
It's my last drink. Where the fuck are you at?
Let me just say you typically drink a 24-ounce or a 16-ounce beverage. You got a 12-ounce tonight.
You know what? That's your motherfucking fault. Get a drink.
You know what? Take that lid off.
No.
Because I'm going to screw that motherfucker directly in your asshole until you fill it with farts.
Yeah, you will.
And I'm going to pop it out and I'm going to put the lid on so I always have it to smell you when you're at work.
You are one nasty person.
That is pretty fucked up.
You wouldn't even say that.
Oh, I did. I say
you
a lot.
You
didn't
think that way.
I say a lot of things that I regret saying later. I'm like, oh, it sounded like it just comes out.
I'm ready for a fire.
Yeah.
I do have to work tomorrow, and you're not going to be home either.
No, I got to meet some old lady for this bigger fucking humidifier. She sets me up early in the morning for this fucking humidifier. I'm like, goddamn.
You're just fine to fucking wake up and do something whenever I'm going to work.
I always
and
do.
And you'll probably come home and go to sleep anyways.
No, I won't. I got shit to do.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
What?
I got to put plastic on the windows.
No. I'll find you to do something.
Motherfucker. To break this bottle over your ass.
Give it to me and I'll break it over your head.
Damn. A lot of that ain't gonna break over my head.
I know.
That one's gonna fucking doom. That's gonna make one of those, oh God, the sound a beer bottle makes when it hits someone's head and doesn't break is heartbreaking. Like, you kind of wish it would have broke. Because it's just like a fucking deafening thud. Oh. Mm-hmm. Especially some of these guys that try to do it on their own, too. Like, yeah, I'm going to reach the bubblehead. Dumbass. And you got to, like...
I would just laugh.
Oh, God. Now, a 40 would be much easier to break over someone's head. But in the event that it didn't break because you hit it in the wrong spot of the bottle, boy, that would piss me the fuck off.
I know.
I know you would. Piss you off. It would sting. My face would get red. I'd breathe heavy. My blood pressure would raise about 60 beats per second. I'm like, grr.
No.
You got such a grip. Like, you don't even expect it. And you still hold on that bitch.
And?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you say when I'm on your dick, too. But we don't talk about that.
You got that gorilla grip. Like gorilla glue.
Baby, can I get this?
What's that?
It's a Pomeranian Chihuahua.
Hey, anyways. We can't have any more dogs.
He needs a friend. Two of the small ones make a medium size.
What's up, friend? That little ankle biter? That's even smaller than him, isn't it? Look, it's smaller than the fucking Bambi plush it's playing with. Are you kidding me?
Baby,
it's got a sweater. It's got a sweater.
Baby.
I love you. But no.
I love you.
We can't have any more dogs.
Babe, two small dogs make a medium, right?
Yeah.
He said I could have a small.
Do you want another dog that acts like, what if it acts like ours? Bless his soul.
Well, he's such a
cute, special dog. Well, you can't help but love him.
Oh, Chihuahuas are much more hyper than
I don't need that.
I'm telling you that.
the night that motherfucker.
Nope. He will run and bounce off shit. And Buster's not even that fast. I'm telling you.
He'd get tired of it.
Who?
Buster.
Yeah, he would.
He'd be like.
He'll
give him that blank stare. Bug eyed.
They would wear each other out and then they underbite. Sleep good. Yes.
You go trot into your son's room. He's like, get this motherfucker away from me. I'm trying to sleep. Or he's like,
Chihuahuas you can't even hardly hold.
Really? Ugh, that's no fun.
They are
no fun. All right. Anyways, thanks for watching, motherfuckers. We'll call you. Yeah, we'll call you tomorrow. We'll catch you bitches tomorrow for Shithole Sucking Sunday.
Saturday.
Shithole Sucking Saturday.
You just thought it was Thursday earlier.
I'm so fucking, yeah.
Yeah.
Deuces, bitches.